let's talk about total knee arthroplasty. Let's answer some questions about this type of knee replacement. What parts of your knee are involved? What does your knee pain feel like, and how does it affect your everyday life? How do you decide when to have a knee replacement? What happens during the surgery? What comes out? What goes in? How long do you have to be in therapy after surgery? And finally, how do you protect your new total knee? Let's now look at the normal anatomy and then show what happens to this normal anatomy during osteoarthritis. First of all, we have the thigh bone. And the thigh bone normally has a nice smooth surface on its ends that's very Teflon-like. And then this sits on the leg bone. The leg bone has the two shock absorbers that are called the meniscus. Again, the end of the thigh bone has a nice smooth surface that's very much in appearance like Teflon. So Teflon-like smooth surface. And these surfaces ride on this shock absorber that's called the meniscus. I'm drawing this shock absorber in three dimension. Shock absorber called the meniscus. So this is the normal parts list. Well, now, what happens with osteoarthritis? Well, with arthritis, we have the following changes that happen first to the thigh bone and also to the leg bone and the meniscus. Now, with the thigh bone, we have a wear and tear of these surfaces that are normally, as we just said, nice and smooth. So here's the end of the thigh bone. Instead of that nice, smooth Teflon surface, we have a lot of jagged edges, large pieces of bone chips that have been thrown off. And in summary, a very worn out surface. So this is severe wear and tear arthritis. On the ends of the thigh bone, as we find on the ends of the leg bone, we can also develop some fairly significant bone spurs. These are bone spurs that end up also causing significant pain. The meniscus degenerates, tears, and by degenerating, I mean gets very thinned out, frayed looking, and often has some big tears in it. This is a torn meniscus. Again, a severe torn meniscus with a severe wear and tear pattern on the thigh bone with significant bone spurs. A picture of advanced osteoarthritis. Finally, I'd like to mention that the space between the bones, if again we look at the thigh bone and the leg bone, instead of a normal space between the bones, we have a collapse of this space between the thigh bone and the leg bone. Sometimes the collapse is on one side, sometimes the collapse is on both sides. So we speak of a joint space collapse in severe osteoarthritis.